post. Gerald Corbyn, great run from Corbyn. He's heading for the corner. He's going to get there. First try on the board for Bradford. Looks like it's going to be a try here, and it is. He skips past the challenge of Hume and touches down in the corner. It's the start of a brand new Stonesbitter Rugby League Championship season. The match of the day features Bradford Northern, one of the leaders of Yorkshire's challenge, against Informed Witness, the team of all talents, coming to you live on the Sports Channel tonight from the famous Oddsall Stadium. And Oddsall is a ground steeped in rugby league tradition and folklore. This was the unforgettable scene in 1954 when Warrington met Halifax in the Challenge Cup final replay. A world record 102,569 people crammed inside the ground to see Warrington win 8-4. Well, the old place has certainly changed a bit since then, but it's still home to Bradford Northern. Hello and welcome to the start of the new British season, a season that promises so much. The Australians are over here in about a month's time to just add a little extra spice to a season that many people are predicting will be the best rugby league championship in years. Well, up in the commentary box with me today will be Kevin Ashcroft, the former Great Britain hooker. He's also the former coach of Lee, Warrington and Salford. Kevin, we have quite a season in store, I think, for the Sports Channel viewers.
Yeah, I think we have, Eddie. I think it's going to be probably the hardest first division for a decade. I think it's going to be a cracker.
So it's Bradford Northern against Widnes today. And, you know, it's been quite a season for Widnes already. They lifted the charity shield in Swansea 3 weeks ago, demolishing Wigan 24 points to 8. One game gone and a trophy already for the Widnes boardroom. It was Wigan again last week, this time in the Lancashire Cup, and again Widnes won, though by just 2 points. Jonathan Davis taking a hand in the closing stages. Just one blot on Widnes' season so far. Martin Afire torn knee ligaments last Sunday. He is out for a month. Well, the sun is shining here in Bradford this evening, and Widnes will be in the change strip of red, white and black, and here they come onto the famous Oddsall pitch. There's Alan Tait just going through your picture, and Jonathan Davis. But Alan Tait is a man who is in the side despite having a dead leg in training this week. He is fit. And there's Davis wearing number 4, firmly established in the centres. Now for Widnes, 8 tries, 17 goals, 66 points for Jonathan Davis already this season. It goes without saying he's the league's top scorer so far. He, along with the rest of the Widnes side, in a rich vein of form. And in a moment, Bradford Northern will be coming onto this pitch. A pitch, as I say, bathed in sunlight. Talking to David Hobbs this week, he said that their regular supporter is the big black cloud that comes over the Oddsall Stadium virtually every Sunday. Well, so far, the big black cloud has kept away, thankfully. It's a glorious autumn evening. Jonathan Davis completing his pre-match build-up in front of what is quite a good crowd here. They've enjoyed their Sunday in the sunshine, and now they are here to welcome Bradford Northern onto the pitch. There's David Hobbs, Brian Noble, and Keith Mumby, the veteran fullback, just going through your picture there. And number 8, David Hobbs, captain, coach, does everything here at Oddsall. 12 Great Britain caps. He's kicked 5 goals already this season. And here's the side that he's named for this evening's game. Keith Mumby is at fullback. Caudle on the wing. Steve McGowan and Tony Marchant are in the centres, 3 and 4. David Cooper wears 5, he's on the wing. The halfbacks, Roger Simpson and Mark Wilson. In the forwards, David Hobbs, Brian Noble, Craig Richards, Carl Fairbank, Paul Medley and John Pendlebury, who's back in the side after missing much of last season because of injury. And Widnes, the world club champions. Alan Tait is at fullback. They make a change in the backs because of the lack of Devereux and Afire. Darren Wright wears 2, Currier is 3, and Davis is 4, with Harvey Howard, a 20-year-old from Waterloo Rugby Union Club, coming in for his debut. Halves are Tony Myler and David Hume, Joe Grimmer, Phil McKenzie, David Smith, Richie Ayres, Emosi Koloto, and Les Holliday, complete the lineup for Wigan. There's the man in the middle, Ray Tennant from Castleford, the referee for tonight's fixture. His biggest moment came in 1989 when he refereed the Challenge Cup final at Wembley. Just about ready then for the start of a brand new season here on the Sports Channel. It's been eagerly awaited by everybody in the north of England and I'm sure throughout the country as well, as Bradford Northern kick off. First touch for Tony Myler and straight away into the arms of Amosi Kolodo. Kevin Ashcroft alongside me. We have been waiting for this moment for quite some time, Kevin. It's going to be a great season.
Yeah, I think it is, Eddie. And to be quite fair, I'm just looking there, Mr. Tennant standing, no messing whatsoever. We've been playing exactly 25 seconds, and straight away he's given a free kick for Brian Noble going in there with the elbow on the head. And quite rightly so, I think, after today's results, and I think there's been about five or six sent off in the British Rugby League today. So Mr. Tennant must have been watching or hearing them results, and he's saying, I'm having none of that today, lads. Get on with playing football. Quite rightly so.
Yes, one of the features of the game today has been the fact that so many players have been sin-binned or sent off. And we'll be running through the results of the day's fixtures for you at half-time. Meantime, it's Widnes who are in possession. And that's David Smith. This now is David Hume. Here's Richie Ayres moving forward on the charge. McKenzie, good reverse pass. This is Currier. Tackled on the ground by Roger Simpson. McKenzie again from dummy half, setting things in motion for Widnes. Hume, the scrum half. Well watched though on that occasion. And this is the last chance in this sequence. High kick from Holiday. This is a tester for the veteran Mumby. Oh, he did well. Took it on the full, and the referee said he took it in play as well, so he's allowed to carry on. Witness caught offside at the play of the ball. So penalty to Bradford Northern, just 10 yards from their own line. And Cooper deposits the ball into touch. So Brian Noble will restart. Here's Steve McGowan, long striding centre, just back from a spell in Australia with Norths. And Northern have lost the ball. Widnes drop on it gratefully. But they don't seem to be able to get hold of it. Now they can. Myler. Great run from Tony Myler. Hume's in support. Again the ball drops to the ground. And who is underneath it in possession under all those bodies? The answer, Widnes, in the shape of Tony Myler. Kolodo juggling. This is Holiday. Grimmer helps it on. Quick hands from Widnes. This is Richie Ayres. Grimmer again. Good play from David Hume. Oh, he saw a gap there. He's gone for it out to the far side. That's Harvey Howard's first touch. He's got some strength, the youngster, but he's just forced into touch a couple of yards short of the line.
Yeah, it was very, very good rugby there from Widnes. David Hume there found a beautiful gap, long ball. And you know Phil McKenzie controls the ball so well from the ruck. There's no question about it here. They take the dummy, Furbanks there, running in nobody's land, really. And to be fair, Harvey Cooper, it's only his second game for Widnes. And doesn't he do a wonderful job? It takes two big lads there to bang him in touch. So that should be the warning signs there for Bradford Northern. Keep your eye on this kid.
That's Harvey Howard, 20-year-old, signed from Waterloo Rugby Union Club on Merseyside last season. Now Noble, the man from dummy half, and again offside at the play of the ball, Widnes caught for the second time. Penalty to Bradford Northern.
I should imagine Dougie will be very upset about that. It was two good tattles there, second tattle, and of all the people to go offside, of course, he's the man farthest away from the play, or from the ruck, as we call it, and that is Harvey Howard, who's just done a magnificent run down the wing. That's just being lazy, and I'm sure Dougie will have something to say to him about it.
Mumby finds touch, and it takes Bradford up to the halfway line. Craig Richards taking the battle on for Bradford Northern. Noble again. He's a local policeman, Brian Noble, by the way. And I think Mr. Tennant saw that that was a knock-on. He orders a scrum down. McGowan, the man who dropped it. And here's the incident again.
Yeah, McGowan looks pretty strong, actually, after his stint down in down under in Australia for North Sydney. He seems to have put a bit of weight on, although he's still long, lean and gangly. And he's one of them players, you know, that once you tattle him, you hurt yourself more on him than you do actually tattling him. He's one of them bony men that shudders you down.
This is Myler. Lovely play from Myler. Alan Tate, long battle to Myler forward. The referee agrees. Currier sets off like a hare out of the trap. But a forward pass is the decision. Here it is. Tate's looking for the break on the near side here, but just a couple of yards forward.
Yeah, I think Meadowlark Lemon would have been proud of that one, Eddie. It was certainly forward, that one, and there's no question about it. What a beautiful ball off Tony Marlow. What a class player this kid is. There's no question about his vision, and you know, we witness how they play off him, both backing up left and right. Then this is where they get to them. And witness, you know, this is the third, I think, consecutive free kick now for offside, and that is really being sloppy, it's being lazy. You've got to get back, lads, get the yardage. You don't want to be giving penalties away, especially in your own 25.
Well, we've been playing just 6.5 minutes. The penalty count is 3 for Bradford, 1 for Widnes so far, so it has been a sloppy start from Widnes so far. But it's going to be a kick at goal from David Cooper, and that's the angle he has. It's a vast bowl, this Odsall Stadium. You notice there, right in the centre of your picture, there's a rather strange-looking part of the turf. All around the pitch here at Bradford Northern, there is the Speedway track, of course. They were using it only last Sunday for the Speedway, the World Speedway Championships. And when they play rugby league here, they have to lay turf down in each corner. And here's the kick now from Davy Cooper. And he struck it well, and that's the first points of the season on the board for Bradford Northern. Substitute in the Premiership final, David Cooper has started the match here tonight, and he's made it Bradford Northern 2 points, Widnes nil. There's Kurt Sorensen, chatting to him just before the start of the match, and he was saying that he should be fit for the Lancashire Cup semi-final on Wednesday against Warrington. Still just a few days away from full match fitness.
Such a driving force behind this Widnes side is Kurt Sorensen. Since the lad's been at Widnes, they've won everything, and he's got a lot of credit has got to go down to Kurt. Such a character, such a strong man, and to be quite fair, off the field, an absolute gentleman.
Here's the incident that you've just seen, and it's a dreadful mistake here from Caudle. Touches it and it goes behind the dead ball line, so Bradford have to drop out from underneath their own sticks.
Just looking at Alan Tate there on the burst, and to be quite fair, Eddie, I've watched the guy many, many times. He isn't running with the power that he can do, and there's no question about it, he isn't 100% fit. His left leg is very heavily strapped up there, and there's no question about it, the kid is struggling at this moment in time, and I wouldn't be surprised if I didn't see Dougie bringing him off and putting him a fitter man.
Gutierrez in possession for Widnes. Little kick over the top from Coloto. Mumby's there and just watches it. He shepherds it behind his own dead ball line. So it'll be a tap out for Bradford Northern on their own 25. They're anxious to get it going again. Marchant will drive it down the middle. Hobbs manages to unload to Pendlebury. I noticed Pendlebury led the side out tonight, so David Hobbs perhaps has made him captain for the season in a new move. Here's Craig Richards. Witness do swamp the player in possession with the ball, don't they, whenever they can. Now Paul Medley. Kick over the top, that's good play. If that bounces kindly, Bradford are in good straits here. It has bounced kindly. This is Marchant. Oh, good saving tackle. Now then, they're just 12 yards short of the line. Medley does well to unload. This is McGowan. Just short of the line. Hobbs, oh, that's a good reverse pass. Cordell's out there. Ball drops to ground, and Myler drops on it gratefully for Widnes.
Yeah, the referee quite rightly there signalled a knock-on, and consequently now it came off a Widnes player, and it'll be a Bradford Northern head and Bradford Northern feed, which is a great advantage for them because they're really in there, what, 10 yards off the line, and to be quite fair, Bradford have had two clear-cut chances in this opening minutes, and they should have put it away. McGowan is looking hungry, and I'm very impressed with this big forward, Mark Wilson has come out doing the feeding onto this Richards, the coloured lad who is really only making yards, but you know, looking to part with the ball, and that's always good to see in a number 10 or a number 8.
Penalty at the scrum for Widnes. This, by the way, is the 18th successive season of second division football in the rugby league. Widnes are one of only five clubs never to be out of the first division, and they top the 17th season table with 318 wins from 498 matches for a total of 656 points. They really have been a measure of consistency, haven't they?
Yeah, they have been really the team to follow, because Wigan's had what, three or four great seasons, but you know, Widnes have been consistent now for what, 12, which is a remarkable stint on anybody's book. They're really the Liverpool of rugby league.
And tonight they're playing in red as well. It's Widnes who are in possession on halfway. Holiday. This is Richie Ayres feeding off him. He looks eager and full of running in this opening fixture for Widnes. Haven't seen too much of the Welshman yet, Jonathan Davis. This is Tate. There he is. He is playing.
Incidentally though, Eddie, he's just having a cough. He might have a bit of a chill. Is it gone a bit cold out there? Nice little cough there off Jonathan. Man, that's the only thing he's done up to now.
Penalty to Widnes. They were all offside, Bradford Northern. And so Jonathan Davis will kick for touch, I think, here. Davis finds touch then. Widnes restart. David Smith, young prop forward, in Kurt Sorensen's place, I think it must be said. Grimmer and Hume doing well, Holiday doing well, Coloto coming forward on the charge. Oh, what a great run from Coloto, just stopped short. But he lost the ball there, and so Bradford get possession back. Good defence from the men from Yorkshire.
Very good defence, but you know, when Widnes really loop the ball out and get it wide and they do these dummy runs, don't they look effective, don't they look good? And you know, that was more luck than good management there on Keith Mumby's part. It was just the way that Coloto fell, and consequently he knocked the ball out of his hands, and thankfully a thankful breath of relief there from Bradford as they regain possession.
And Hobbs kicks, and it goes all along the ground and finds touch, and Hobbs got a clatter in the process. There's David Hobbs, player coach. Done such a good job since taking over from Ron Willey of Australia midway through last season. He's galvanised the side, rekindled the fortunes. And this is the kick he's just put in, and he got a right clattering from David Hume.
Well,
The scrum is a bit of a shambles, the referee though says. Play on, I think, and Bradford have possession. They've brought in new rules this season, haven't they, about scrummaging to try and tidy up the scrums in rugby league?
Yeah, they have, Eddie, and I think it'll be another, you know, seven-day wonder. When we always bring these new rules in, we tend to punish them and crucify them for a couple of weeks and then forget all about them. So I won't put too much thought down to that. I think we'll just get on with the game, and to be quite fair, the referees are handling the scrums pretty well at this moment in time.
Here's Craig Richards again. Good battling, driving run. Every time he gets it, he's prepared to put the ball under his arm and gallop forward. Again, though, offside, at the play the ball, by Widnes. Referee Ray Tennant started in this vein. Widnes have surely learnt their lesson by now, because they've conceded the first points of the game and are going to have another pot shot at goal, Bradford, from another offside decision at the play the ball.
Yeah, but you must give full credit to Bradford Northern there, you know, because it was Richards again who did the busting run. But not only did the busting run, he held, took three players out with him, but it's the way he got up and played the ball. It was a magnificent quick play the ball, and it's very difficult to get back onside in a situation like that.
So it's going to be David Cooper again. He's what, 45 yards out, but right in centre of the field. There's not too much breeze out there, but he's taking his time and measuring the distance carefully. Here he comes now, right footed. Just swung away of the left hand upright as we watched, and it allowed Darren Wright to bring the ball back into the field of play. Here's Les Holiday again. Widnes haven't lost since they put him in the side against Wigan towards the back end of last season. It's a run of 10 straight victories. McKenzie at the acting halfback position. Again, offside at the play of the ball. This time, Bradford caught. And it was Steve McGowan, I think. And nice to see in the background there in that shot briefly, the pom-pom girls. There they are. Don't see too many of those in British Rugby League. I think we should see more, Kelly.
Yes, a little bit older, actually, are they? Some about 18 or 19 would do fine.
You'll have the Wibbins Libbers on your tail at the end of this evening. You know that, don't you?
Only a quip, I'd only a quip.
Here come Widnes again then. Hume and Holiday working the run around perfectly. Alan Tate coming forward on the burst, but is he fit? Well, he had a dead leg in training on Thursday. There was some doubt about him.
And now I think he's got a dead head, Eddie, because that was a really high tattle, and the person in charge there, I think, is having a go is Furbanks, and there's no question about it, Mr. Tennant's giving it to him in no uncertain in words there. He's telling him, any more sunshine, it's a long walk home, and you can get in that bath on your own. And there's no question about it, Alan Tate isn't running really like he can run. Usually he would have bust that tattle, but you know, when he's getting to the man to go through the gap, he is stopping, and that is an indication that the guy isn't 100% fit.
Well, John Pendlebury, the Bradford Northern captain, has obviously got to tell his forwards to watch that sort of tackle. 8-match ban is just around the corner for anyone sent off for high tackling these days. John Pendlebury must tell his boys just to settle down. Carl Furbank, the man who was penalised.
That should be a very interesting conversation between John Pendlebury and the rest of the Bradford lads, because John Pendlebury is a right down and out Wiganer, so I should imagine he'll be thee-ing and thy-ing, and all the Bradford lads will be saying, what the hell are you talking about, John?
So Jonathan Davies has this kick to level the scores. He's been in fine form with the boots, 17 goals already this season. There's the angle he has. And he doesn't miss those. A player of Davis's calibre, the touch judge with the yellow flag, Mr. Muir, dropped it originally, but signals that the kick was good. Goal scorer Jonathan Davis, that's 18 goals for him this season, and it gives us the scoreline now of Bradford 2, Widnes 2. And on my watch, just over 19 minutes gone. So all square here at Oddsall, but Bradford have the ball back. Greg Richards doing a good job in that prop position for Bradford so far. It's a good game, this. It's Medley. Now then, what can Bradford do here? Pendlebury. Oh, thundered to the ground there by Grimmer. Burbank again, this time putting the nut down and driving forward. Takes the play the ball to himself. He's allowed to go on and he's gone all the way. That's great play from Burbank. And aren't they delighted? And no wonder. Carl Furbank, there was no one marking him at the play of the ball, tapped it to himself and through the gap he went. And look, although Tate tried to take him low down, they couldn't stop him.
Yeah, again, that was really slack marking on witness's part there. It's crucial that you tie the block up, especially the play of the ball, because little gaps do are created there when you're looking for the ball out wide, and all of a sudden a big fella like Furbank, who's pretty quick off the mark, to be fair, he's very strong 10 yard out, and didn't he use his body and his weight well there to stretch over for really what could be a very, very vital score.
Well, it's his first try of the season. They've had a couple of Yorkshire Cup matches, Bradford Northern, already this season, but that's the first time that Furbank has got over, and the extras have been added by Davy Cooper. Interesting statistic about Furbank, two tries against Widnes in the victory in March. But that is Davy Cooper, the goal scorer, and it's given us that scoreline, Bradford 8, Widnes 2. And I think Widnes know that they have got a match on their hands here, but there's the Bradford bench. And they look very happy, don't they? And well, they might.
Yeah, they look very happy indeed. I mean, that is a crucial score. I mean, a lot of pressure there from Bradford, and it's nice when you're putting a lot of pressure on to make it count. Widnes probably only had one clear-cut chance, and of course, a brilliant tackle by Keith Mumby stopped Coloto going in on the far corner. But, you know, it's a very even game, and Widnes are a side that when they are down, that's really when they do start playing. And so long as Bradford can continue doing what they're doing, and that is holding them in the ruck and stopping the ball getting wide, then, you know, you've got to fancy Bradford.
So it's a goal line dropout from underneath his own posts by Mumby. Widnes back in possession. Myler takes the play up to the 25. This is Tate. Now this is McKenzie. Grimmer, Hume, Coloto. That's a move that we've seen quite a few times already this evening. Working quite well. Hume again. Holiday, lovely backhanded pass. Good support from Tony Myler. A chat in the tackle, how on earth he can with the arm round his neck, I don't know. But here come Widnes again. Ayres, good tackling from Roger Simpson. Tate at the play the ball, little kick over the top from Holiday. Oh, and McGowan didn't hardly jump for that. Referee waves play on, and not only that, wipes the tackle count clear. They've got six more here. Looked forward though, that one, and it was. Referee agrees again. Well, what a waste of the opportunity there for Widnes. The ball was played out to the far side, and again it went a couple of yards forward. That was Jonathan Davis whose pass went forward this time, under pressure though from McGowan. So Bradford now will try and clear their lines, bring that ball down the middle. Good run from McGowan. There's Doug Lawton, the Widnes coach, on the bench, not looking too happy, but there again, even if his side are 40 or 50 points ahead, you have to struggle to get a smile off him.
Yeah, you do. I should imagine Dougie will be on his, what, 20th or 25th cigarette up to now, because I know, being sat on the bench at the side of Dougie a few times, he really goes through the cigarettes. And, you know, he's got a lot on his mind at this moment in time. And really, I think that the credit must go to the forwards of Bradford Northern, and especially this Craig Richards, who's having a storming game. No question about it. He's really controlling Coloto, because Coloto's hell of a big man and takes some stopping. But Richards, at this moment in time, has been up to the task and really cut him out of the game.
McKenzie from acting halfback. Here's Myler. And they know that Myler is the danger man. There are four players around him there, and it takes three of the four to bring him to ground. And the referee, I think, saying that Myler had the ball ripped out of his arms there.
Yeah, that was a hell of a good decision there by Mr. Tennant, and there's no question about it, he did. Furbanks there, just hoping that the referee wasn't looking. All good rugby players do this, especially when you're just going down to ground, when you're a bit relaxed, you've not got control of the ball, and he did snatch it, and that's a good decision. And again, this is a position really where Widnes should make it pay. They've had a lot of territorial advantage up to now, but they haven't made it pay, so let's hope that they can do something about it.
6-4, the penalties in Widnes's favour. And here they come again. Coloto. McKenzie's the man at acting halfback. Hume's first receiver helps it on to Holiday. Oh, Holiday and Hume in the run around. The ball's gone to ground. And Mark Wilson has collected for Bradford Northern. Good play from Bradford. Alert to the danger. Sloppy play from Widnes. And Bradford on the roll here. This is Caudle. Ducks under the challenge well. 32 tries from Gerald Caudle, the Welshman, last year. Earned him one call-up for Great Britain. Didn't make it to New Zealand, though. And from someone in his first season to a veteran, Keith Mumby, the fullback. But doing an effective job just the same. So is this fella, Craig Richards. Hobbs, good reverse pass. Hobbs will hoist that kick high, and here's a tester for Alan Tate. What's the Great Britain fullback capable of? Well, he's capable of taking it out of the air.
Yeah, Alan Tate's very, very sound on the, you know, especially the high ball, and really the ball's around the ground. I mean, he's been taking them in rugby union all his life. The touch judge is coming on over some incident. I think, again, that was an elbow went in after the tackle, and there's no question about it. Mr. Tennant now will have words with him, and I should imagine that this will be definitely a penalty to Widnes, again, which will hope to ease the pressure, because they have been under pressure. They've been under the hammer a little bit here.
They have indeed, and it's Carl Furbank who's been pulled out by the referee. John Pendlebury having a word. It was an elbow, I think, in the face on young Harvey Howard, the winger. And he's got Sinbin, Carl Furbank. And it'll be 10 minutes before we see him back on the pitch.
Again,
and
really,
this is the reason why. He tackled Howard. He did well by bringing him down, and then bang, look at that, right in the chin. A forearm smash that Mick McManus would have been proud of. And they're offside again, right away from the penalty. So Bradford showing just a touch of indiscipline here. Maybe the fact they're 8-2 ahead has gone to their heads.
Yeah, maybe. It was really no need for that one, because he'd done the job. He'd put the guy to ground. All he had to do was get up and play the ball. But, you know, plainly seen a beautiful forearm smash. And no question about it. Having been warned once, then Mr. Tennant had no option really, only to send him to the sinking for 10 minutes. You know, Widnes are looking sloppy, and again they've lost possession, and again they're offside, and this is only down to Bradford's brilliant play the ball. Hobbs has really got him playing the ball well.
He certainly has. We were down here on Tuesday just watching them in training, and they really were relishing the task of facing Widnes this weekend, their opening match of the season, the first match here on the Sports Channel. David Hobbs said he wanted to put a bit of a show on for us, and so far he is doing that. David Hume is injured, just receiving some treatment. Meanwhile, play continues at the other end. Ball bouncing round all over the place. Referee says knock on. And so the two sides again will scrum down. This is where it all happened. Caudle fumbled. Just took his eye off the ball at the vital moment. Slipped through his hands and hit the deck. So it'll be Widnes's head and ball, and David Hume fit again. And back in the action, we'll feed the scrum. Myler, shaped to kick and then left two in his wake, made a good ball to Alan Tate. Good play from Alan Tate, that's a great run. Good support here from Andy Currier, unloading in the tackle, but a little bit too quickly. And referee says that's a penalty to witness. And the Bradford Northern fans are not happy, and Kevin Ashcroft shaking his head as well.
Yeah, it was a split decision, that one. It was accidentally touched there by John Pendlebury on the ground, and it rolled out to a Bradford player who actually was stood in front of John, so technically he is offside, but a lot of players there would have given accidental offside, which would have resulted in a scrum. But not to be, so now it's a free kick, which would hopefully all witness back into the game, and 2 points at this moment in time really they need, because they have been flagging a little bit in the last, 10 to 15 minutes.
Handling errors so far make interesting reading. Widnes have made 7 and Bradford 5. But this is a penalty to Widnes. As you see, just a yard or so outside the Bradford Northern 25. And for a goal kicker of Jonathan Davis's calibre, that isn't a difficult angle. 17 before today, 1 in the bag already, so that's 18 goals for Jonathan Davis. His season's tally of points now 68. Will he hit the magical 70 mark here with this one? And the answer's no. Well, Jonathan maybe has left his shooting boots back home in Widnes.
Yeah, it was really a simple kick, that, for a guy of Jonathan Davis's calibre. But, you know, when things are not going right for you, then they don't go right. And at this moment in time, things are just not going right for Widnes. But let's give some credit to Bradford Northern, because they're making things happen for themselves, and they're harassing Widnes into mistakes. And that is an absolutely stupid mistake there by Tatey, punting it straight into touch on the first tackle, and really giving, you know, Bradford Northern all the advantage. They've got enough advantage without giving it them, and they are now camped out again just outside, the 30-metre mark. And again, the pressure is on. It's Bradford Northern's head and ball, and anything can happen from here.
Mark Wilson puts the ball in and then goes ferreting in between the legs to bring the ball out. And he's allowed to carry on by the referee. Ayres completes the tackle on him. Marchant's the acting halfback. This is Simpson. This is the captain, Pendlebury. My word, he was brought to ground there by young David Smith. Craig Richards again. What a good game he's had in the opening half hour or so here. Hobbs again. Oh, and as the ball was laid out, it just went, I think, a couple of yards in front of Caudle, and he couldn't quite get hold of it.
I think David Hobbs actually was caught in two minds there, because just as he was weaving the ball out there to create the overlap, Cordell stayed on the wing, of course, and McGowan cut inside, which resulted in, in taking the eye off the man in the gap, and resulted in the ball going straight into touch. Again, silly mistakes, especially, I think that was the second tackle. And this has been a feature of this game, actually, that both sides have not really controlled the ball. And, you know, to be a good side and to be a side winning all the time, you've got to control the ball, you've got to make the opposition work on you in defence, because defence tires you out quicker than attack.
One or two of the players have received plenty of hammer in this match already. There's the team tackle count. Bradford have made 41 tackles, Widnes 39. I must say, with Widnes having met Wigan twice, Leeds having met Bradford, Castleford being involved as well in the opening 2 weeks of the season, even before this league programme got underway today, it does make you wonder whether we're playing a bit too much rugby league in this country, Kevin, and too much rugby league at the very highest level.
Yeah, I think we are, actually, and I just cannot understand why we should be playing cup competitions of that high degree before the season starts. I'm sure it can be fitted in either at the end of the season or halfway through the season, whatever, because it does really, it can spoil teams with the injuries receiving them matches. And after all the hard work and close season training you've done, I think it's just unnecessary.
And of course, because of that, we don't see Devereux and we don't see a fire here tonight, but we do see this fella Jonathan Davis. But that's a great tackle on him. Super tackle from Keith Mumby, that. Smith gives it to Darren Wright. Pass inside, Tate waited for it to bounce and then released the ball again, and Mark Wilson dropped on it for Bradford Northern. Noble going on his own from the acting half-back position. Dummy half, they call them, in an Australian programme you may have seen earlier on today. Noble again. Hobbs. Good punishing kick from Hobbs. Driving Widnes back towards their own 22. Such an experienced campaigner, and he really has galvanised things here at Odsall, hasn't he, Kevin, since he took over from Ron Willey, the Australian?
Yeah, he has indeed, and there's no question about it that the tackling is well, the hitting man and ball, the stopping the Widnes flow, and, you know, there's not a lot of teams can do this. And that, again, is a penalty, a very silly penalty. Joe Graham is arguing with him, mate, but I tell you, it won't make any difference. He won't change his mind. You might as well get back, get in defence and get ready for some work, Joe, because he ain't going to alter his decision. And the main thing is there, again, advantage. You know, head and ball and you give a free kick away, it's absolutely silly. And I'm sure Dougie Lawton, you know, I'd like to be a fly on the dressing room wall in a couple of minutes, because Dougie's going to have a lot to say about lost possession, not controlling the ball and giving away really stupid free kicks.
Penalties have gone Bradford's way, 9-6, and that's exactly what Kevin Ashcroft's talking about. Too many penalties conceded by Widnes in the opening half here. That's a good run from Medley, and the referee, I think, saying that Medley didn't play that ball properly, so there's another basic and elementary error, this time from Paul Medley. So it's a penalty to Widnes, and a penalty I think that they will gratefully accept from deep in their own territory. And Tate will find touch on this near side. Well, considering they've lost quite a few big names in the summer, Kelvin Skerritt going to Wigan, Paul Harkin to Leeds, Russell Stewart to Huddersfield, and Graham Mackey home to Australia, they've done well here, Bradford Northern, to be in this situation after just, 36 minutes or so of the new season. And they really are rattling Widnes at the moment, pushing this team of all talents out of their stride. Possession too. Roger Simpson, tourist to New Zealand and Papua New Guinea this summer. Noble, Richards. Oh, good challenge on him by Smith. Made him release the ball. Given Widnes the possession back, but immediately Widnes again surrender possession to Keith Mumby. And Dougie Lawton is on cigarette number 26. Carl Furbank has returned to the fray, having served his 10 minutes in the sin bin. Medley. Pendlebury. Oh, he loses it too. So there have been plenty of handling errors here this evening. Here's the latest one from John Pendlebury. Look, he, I think, almost tried to unload the ball there, but David Hume had the arm clamped to his side. And handling errors, Widnes have made 11, Bradford have made 8. And Holiday, I think, was trying to steal the march there, but Bradford caught offside at the play the ball. Craig Richards, the offender. Davis deposits the ball in touch. So we're coming up to half time here, and Joe Grimmer has just brushed Brian Noble almost aside. Here's David Smith. Good driving run from him. They're just 15 metres now from the Bradford try line. Hume. This is Holiday. Ayres. Good tackling again from Bradford, not giving him an inch, and this time Lichier's a little bit too quick. There was a man marking him at the play the ball. He tried to play it to himself, And I think I'm right in saying, Kevin, that is not allowed if there's a man in front of you.
No, he wasn't looking then at all, Richard Ayres, because he was definitely marked, no question about it, and he knows the rules like everybody else, and, even the witness lads are shaking their heads and calling him a stupid so-and-so, because that was, again, the second tattle, really a great advantageous position there for witness, and they just do a stupid mistake and throw the advantage away, because it's all about territorial play. You can only score when you're in your opponent's half. You cannot do it when you're in your own half. So, really, the half-time route has gone now, Eddie, and I'm telling you, Dougie Lawton will have a lot to say in that dressing room in the next 10 minutes.
So it's half-time at Oddsall. Bradford Northern have rattled Widnes. They've knocked them out of their stride here, and the Bradford public giving these players a great ovation as they leave the field. Bradford coach David Hobbs will be absolutely delighted with the half-time scoreline that is Bradford Northern 8, Widnes 2. We'll have the second half for you after... And just looking down the list, I think that David Hume was the top tackler for Widnes, and the top tackler for Bradford Northern was Craig Richards, this man in your picture now. And as far as we're concerned up here, Craig Richards was the man of the first half. Only 19 years old. But where was Jonathan Davis in that first half? Well, he's under so much pressure wherever he goes. We obviously put pressure on him as well, we being the media. We're always expecting fireworks every time he touches the ball. But not so far today. Maybe the next 40 minutes have fireworks in store from Jonathan. Scrum count, Bradford Northern 5, Widnes 4. You're up to date with the facts and figures, I think, of that first half. Penalties, Bradford have conceded 11, Widnes 7. And... the other important news I should tell you is that Chris Ashurst has come on into the side with number 15 on his back for Widnes, and he has replaced Joe Grimmer. So Jonathan Davis kicks off. Bradford Northern's coach David Hobbs, number 8, going through the picture there, has decided to stay as you are. And no wonder for the first half, particularly from this fellow, Craig Richards. But there's Ashurst on in the second half for Joe Grimmer. Ashurst, who played in the Charity Shield and made just 3 appearances last season and 1 as substitute. Well, he's come on as substitute here tonight. Tate has to retreat right back to his own try line to pick up that ball. Makes only 8 yards and then is met by the Bradford wall. A good half for Bradford Northern. Lots of statistics at the start of this second half. The most important one, though, Kevin, is that Bradford are ahead 8-2.
Yes, indeed, Eddie, and thoroughly deserves in so, because, they seem to have controlled the ball a lot more in the right possession and in the right positions. And there's no question about it that the tackling has been really first class. They have stubbed the ball out from Widnes, and when you do this with Widnes, they get a bit frustrated and seem to panic and try and panic passing in positions that are not on. And this has really been the first half, that's what it's been all about. And you've got to give full credit to this lad that we've just mentioned before, Craig Johnson, because he's had an absolutely storming game in blotting out the big runs of Coloto and of course the link-ups from Frank from John Myler. Absolutely super game, and there's no question about it that without a doubt that I think that Bradford, see, everybody has a bogey side, and I think Widnes's bogey side is Bradford. As it proved last year, I think they did the double on them.
They did indeed, they did the double last season against Widnes, and they've won only one of their last 6 first division visits here, have Widnes, and they've been caught offside again. So not a great record against Bradford here at Oddsall. Although they did, of course, lift the premiership against Bradford at Old Trafford in May. They got revenge for those 2 league defeats. But at the moment, it's Bradford's night here at Oddsall. And they're coming forward again now with Carl Ferber. Roger Simpson. Enveloped by 3 defenders. One of them was mostly Coloto, and Roger Simpson comes up to about Coloto's navel. That's another good kick, but just slightly off beam. Ball goes dead behind Widnes's goal line, and so that will be a tap from their own 25. David Smith driving down the middle again for Widnes. And here's Ashurst. He's got a bit of weight, got plenty of size, but going nowhere because Craig Richards was there to stop him. Now Coloto. That was a better ball from Holiday to Coloto, but with those three round him, Coloto was stopped dead in his tracks. Myler. Referee says that the tackle was completed standing up. Nice little kick over the top from Holiday. But Caudle collects. Now this fella is a speed merchant. Good play, or just went a yard or two forward maybe. Well, an inch or two, maybe not a yard. Just slightly forward anyway. Referee right on hand. Scrum down again. And David Hume will feed. Widnes have head and ball. And not only that, they have possession eventually. The scrum was an absolute shambles again, wasn't it? But the important thing as far as Widnes are concerned is they have possession. And Simpson has done a very good job on Myler tonight. He's snuffed him out of the game. Because when he's on song, Widnes are on song. Here's Ashurst. His legs will be fresh. I must say, the Bradford Northern public are warming to their side here. They beat Leeds in the first round of the Yorkshire Cup a couple of weeks ago and then were totally humiliated at Valley Parade last week against Castleford in the second round of the Yorkshire Cup. And I bet a lot of Bradford's hearts hit their boots and thinking that this is going to be another of those in-and-out seasons from them. But my word, they've stuck to their guns well and they've taken Widnes on here tonight. And Mumby will have to be quick, and he almost fumbles it. He does fumble it. Referee waves play on. McKenzie followed up his own kick. Davis. McKenzie reorganising at the play of the ball. Quick hands from Widnes. Myler again. They really are trying to find the way through, but Bradford closing the gate at the moment. They're not far, a couple of metres from the line. Long pass to Coloto. This is Richie Ayres. Davis was there in support, just couldn't get the ball out to him. Davis is hunting for a try on this near side. Here he is. Little dummy. Releases the pass again. They keep it going. Good play that. This is Smith. Great pass from him. They're doing well keeping this ball alive. Tate. It's still alive. They've got a man out now. If they go wide, they can't fail. Darren Wright has scored. Good try from Widnes that. And that's what Widnes really are all about. They never let the ball die, although there were times there when it looked as though the chance had gone. Widnes weren't to be denied. They worked the ball out wide to Darren Wright, and he was in the corner, courtesy of Andy Currier.
Yeah, that was a beautiful laid-off ball there by Andy Currier, showing in all his experience. And Darren Wright, you know, long-striding, very strong lad, and he's unstoppable in that situation. And really, the cover across there did well to get there, but they couldn't just nail the man. And really, that ball was dead from Widnes on three occasions. It hit the floor, he was knocked back, and everything went on there really to create really a good try. And what can you say? This is Widnes. Everybody thinks they're dead and buried, and the opposition just thinks, oh, we've tackled him, the ball's gone to ground, they have a little minute, and bang, bang, zip, zip, and thank you very much, straight in the corner. And that really is what Widnes wanted, because they were they was going out of this game, and Bradford were getting on top, because Bradford are doing very well. And Dougie now is having a bit of chewing gum there. He's having an orange. He's off the cigarettes, or is it a sandwich or something, and he will be definitely feeling a lot better, I think, for that try, because to be quite fair, Bradford have really been on top, and they have done really what you can only do against Widnes, is to do man and ball, and they've done it very, very well today.
So Jonathan Davies has this kick. He kicked one off the touchline to win the match against Wigan last week. Can he kick one off now to level the scores here at Oddsall? Well, that was not a Jonathan Davies special.
That is commonly termed, Eddie, as a flapper.
It certainly flapped its way to the post. It didn't sail over. So, Bradford 8, Widnes 6. And on my watch, 8.5 minutes of the second half gone. So, Widnes back in the hunt here. It's not been a bad start to the season. The results that have gone around the country, as you heard at half-time, a couple of draws. Sheffield, you would never have banked them to get a point at Wigan. You probably, with respect to Warrington, wouldn't have thought they'd have toppled Castleford. And what's going to happen here in the next half hour or so?
Now we'll see a bit of fighting spirit from Widnes, and we'll probably see a little bit of hard tackling. Furbank having a goal there at Holiday, and Medley having a goal. And this is what it's all about now. I think the adrenaline is running on both sides with the score so close. I think both teams realise that the next score could be the winner. So now the adrenaline will really be flowing, and we shall see now a little bit of what they call unarmed combat.
And it was a little kick there that Paul Medley put on the grounded Les Holiday that has brought about that penalty. And Widnes have possession from it as well, and this is what Widnes are so good at, flinging that ball about, spinning it through the hands. And as you saw a couple of minutes ago, Darren Wright in the corner, but you've got to take the ball with you. Widnes have it, but the referee says that that was a knock-on by Amosi Kaloto. Yes, it's the opening day of the season. Amosi went without the ball. Good strong play from Tony Marchant, this.
It was very weak tackling from Widnes too, Eddie, there again. And, you know, as I said, the next try could be the real crunch match. And there's no question about it. It's end-to-end stuff now, and both sides are very, very evenly matched.
Noble in possession then for Bradford Northern. Well, that had to be a knock-on, surely. He lost the ball anyway, whatever he did. I think he went to play it quickly, and the ball just dropped to the floor. Here it is again. Furbank, yes, see, he let it slip out of his fingers. And he's been penalised for it correctly by the referee. But Bradford have possession from the scrum.
That was unbelievable. That was Widnes's ball, and for some reason the second row just jacked it straight back to the waiting arms of the Bradford scrum half. Thank you very much. One they shouldn't have won. But you know, Furbank's there when he was trying to play the ball to himself. Good idea. But unfortunately, when you get some of these forwards trying to start thinking, they make a hash of it, and that's what happened then.
And that's a former forward doing the talking.
I was an intelligent forward, Eddie.
Here's an intelligent forward too, David Hobbs. A little workhorse, the Bradford player coach. Mark Wilson, Pendlebury, Wilson again. Nice run from McGowan on the blind side. Ashurst alive to it, so was McKenzie. Hume adding his weight for good measure. Pendlebury again. Played three times at Wembley, John Pendlebury. Twice for Halifax and once for Wigan in his career. He'd love to get back there again with Bradford, I'm sure. Attempted drop goal, and it's a good one. David Hobbs, the drop goal specialist for his side. Didn't take a moment to set up. The ball moved across the line. Hobbs right in front of the sticks. and the player coach has done the job for his side. 1 point, but it's better to go up there and come back with a point than come back with nothing at all. Do you agree?
Yeah, there's an old saying, if you get down there and you can't penetrate the defence, come away with one. And, you know, that was really well worked, because the guy attacking half-back gave a beautiful ball out to him. They must have done that 1,000 times before. And then, of course, Brian Noble straight out to his skipper and coach. And what a beautiful drop goal. It was right in the middle of the sticks. Well worked. And I'm sure a thing that they've rehearsed in training. And it's a valuable point at this stage of the game.
Indeed so. It stretched the lead. Simpson now for Bradford. They've got a spring in their step again. Craig Richards, great run from the big book fella. Only 19, would you believe it? And that was a good tackle from Hume. He pulled Davy Cooper into touch there.
What a storming game this Johnson's having. You know, 19-year-old, absolutely brilliant run, no question about it. Craig Richards, for me, up to now, definitely the man of the match. And look at this beautiful laid-off ball for a man of, really, you know, very few years. 77 games, actually, in the first team, and showed then as if he was a veteran. And again, witness, indiscipline again is going to cost them, lose them yardage, and it's all about territorial advantage. And as long as Bradford are pegging away there in the witness 25 and the time's ticking away, they'll be quite happy, and it's really Widnes who have really got to do something about it, and they can't do it out their own 25.
Cooper deposits the ball into touch right on that Widnes 25 line. So here we go again, Bradford Northern turning the screw once more. Great run from Medley. Noble at the heart of it all again. This is Mark Wilson. Good play from him to Furbank. On the run around, it's Wilson again. Tackled by Andy Currier. 12 months ago, Currier getting ready to play in the grand final in Australia for Balmain. Maybe David Smith there having the knee up against David Hobbs. Pendlebury. Here's Richards again. Such a strong game from this 19-year-old tonight. Hobbs again. Mumby joins the line. This is the last tackle of this sequence. Is Hobbs going to have another drop? It's another drop goal. And this time it was John Pendlebury. So he said to his coach, obviously, whatever you can do, I can do. Pendlebury with the drop goal. Deadly, straight between the sticks. And another point goes on to the Bradford Northern total. John Pendlebury, the goal scorer.
No flukes about them, Eddie. You know, them's well set up. Two drives to the sticks. No, if you notice, not going onto the wide side of the field. And really, what I do like, I'm very impressed about, is, of course, this Craig Johnson, the way that they're using him outside. He's running into the little guys, if you can call Andy Currie little guys, but he's very effective outside, and all the damage has been done there with him running wide. And that's good coaching in anybody's books. And John Pendlebury, of course, he's dropped a few goals in his time, and it was well set up again.
It was well set up, and Ian Proctor, our statistician, reminds me that in 1987 at Wembley for Halifax, John Pendlebury did exactly that. Dropped a goal for Halifax that day, that in the end won them the trophy, won them the famous Challenge Cup. I wonder whether that has won them this match here, but this is McGowan. What a great run. Oh, he's chipped it ahead himself. He had men in support either side, and he really should have passed that inside, because that was a try, and that possibly was the winning money for Bradford, and it went to begging. A great run from McGowan, and look at the support he had on either side, Marchant and Simpson, and he elected to kick it round Tate himself. Darren Wright was there and just shepherded the ball behind the dead ball line. That was a try.
Oh, I can't believe that one. Obviously, he'll be really upset about that one, because the simple reason was it looked like then McGowan was a little bit ostracised. He's been playing in Australia and he had the blinkers on there. He didn't look, and there's no question about it. If you give that Andy Simpson, Simpson would have no question about it. He would have been under the H's, and that would have been good night Vienna, game set and match to Bradford.
It still might, because Bradford are on the roll here. They really are driving holes in this Widnes defence. Simpson again here. He was in support a minute or two ago. Now he's trying to get underneath the tacklers himself. Furbank. Look at the yardage these forwards are making, and they're unable to unload the ball in the tackle too. Here's Caudle, now he's picking up pace. Ooh, he was almost round there. Well done, Coloto. Just tapped his ankles and David Smith completed the tackle. Hobbs and Noble. Noble's going to be pushed into touch, and he is.
That isn't a bad thing, actually, being tackled into touch. I know it's witnesses head and ball, but it's better another one tackle than it would have been the handover. So at least, you know, they've some chance of getting the ball, or at least penning witness down again in their own 25. Free kick there for pushing before the ball was in, quite right. But a lot of teams are adapting this style of play now, whereas when you know it's not your head and ball, you might as well get in a pushing position and just try and steamroll over the other pack. Unfortunately, they did it before the ball was in.
Well, witness have had to make 27 consecutive tackles against Bradford Northern without seeing the ball themselves. So it just shows you the sort of pressure that witness have been under in the last two or three minutes or so. Great pressure from Bradford. They really should have had more than just the two drop goals. There was a try that went begging when McGowan kicked ahead and he had players on either side in support. However, witness still in the hunt despite all that work they've had to do in defence. Only 4 points adrift and 19 minutes gone. The cheers for witness. Myler. Good play from Myler. Tate on the burst and in full tilt. This is the fifth tackle for witness in this sequence. So last chance, Holiday will hoist the kick. It's almost gone backwards. Mumby gathers it in. Witness just not firing on all cylinders here tonight, but Bradford most certainly are.
Yeah, I think witness will, you know, missing the leadership, of course, of the general, Kurt Sorensen, who really organises the forwards so well, and that is really what's been missing and lacking today. They're running hard, they're looking for gaps, but they're running without, point or without direction. And this is what Kurt Sorensen does very well when he's on the field.
Well, will they run with direction now? Here's Holiday, good ball inside from him to Coloto. McKenzie, who is the playmaker at the play the ball situation, so too is Holiday, so too is this fellow, Tony Myler. They're just 10 yards short of the line now. And the referee, I think, has penalised Bradford for not allowing Myler to regain his feet after the tackle. Keith Mumby not happy with the decision, but this is why witness have a penalty in front of the sticks. Two players holding down Myler, Mumby leaning on him, lying on him, although by the looks of things, to be fair, Myler had his head in a bit of a headlock there.
Yeah, he did indeed. I don't suppose Keith would be too upset about giving that one away, actually, because there's an old saying, 2 points is better than six. And witness in the last couple of minutes was looking well, he was getting the ball wide and really putting Bradford Northern under a bit of pressure. So it'll be a bit of a breather for the Bradford lads, and at least when they kick off, they're back down in the witness half again. So all in all, it's a good free kick as far as Bradford go.
But with the kick from this position and Jonathan Davis, the goal kicker, it should be 2 points to witness and 2 points nearer the Bradford total. Here he comes, and this time he's successful. So Jonathan Davis has found his trusty boots at half-time. He's the goal scorer.
I did lose a bet, actually, with Jonathan Davis. You know, when I first met Jonathan and I looked at his face and his beautiful nose, I said, Jonathan, I can't see you holding that so straight for the both six-week-an-hour game. And he's proved me wrong, so he must have either good vision or ducking very well, because it's still straight. But, you know, it'll be interesting to see him at the end of the season.
10-8, Bradford ahead. So just 2 points in it. And it's quite a match to start us off here on the season on the Sports Channel. You said that Jonathan Davis hasn't had too much of a match here this evening, but my word, he's been well watched by the Bradford Northern players and defenders. They really have done their homework. They know that Davis is the man to watch. Good driving run from fullback Keith Mumby. Here's Hobbs. Here's McGowan. Oh, breaking through two tackles and unloading to Marchant. And Marchant can move two off either foot. Here's Medley. Good tackling from young Harvey Howard. Here's Craig Richards again. Look at him wriggling and trying to get away from the tacklers and the attention of those three witness players. Coming on the blind side. Ooh, Caudle. Almost, but not quite.
You know, I'm very, very impressed with the play the balls of Bradford Northern. They're really getting up and playing the ball. And then, there again, nearly catch Widnes out on the hop, because that was a beautiful short down ball straight out to Cordell, who's a big lad, can run, and you know, very dangerous, what, 15 yards out from the line. We're just looking at Keith Mumby there before, when he come through on that riveting run, and you know, what a great professional he's been, and what a great servant he's been to Bradford Northern Rugby League Club. If there's any young kid watching, if you want to be a good pro, have a look at Keith Mumby. What a player, what a great lad.
Yes, over 570 appearances for Bradford Northern, nearly 2,000 points. He's been the Northern Player of the Year just seven times. Keith Mumby, Bradford Northern's fullback. He's the last line of defence here now, though, tonight. Everyone else has moved up. Mumby is back there on his own as Widnes pile on the pressure again. I think that one went out on the fall from Phil McKenzie. So again, the ball will be brought back. The two sides will scrum down. And it's going to be Bradford's head and ball.
Phil McKenzie's been very, very quiet today for some reason. I've not seen him having a go from acting half-back. He's not been his ferreting self. And he's not backing up like he can. Whether he's, you know, got the flu or whatever, I don't know. But he's been really had a quiet game, you know, to his standards today, Eddie. Would you agree with that?
There's one or two of the Widnes boys who have not performed as we know they can. But I don't think we should take anything away from Bradford Northern, because it has been a superb display from them. And David Hobbs really has had his boys wound up. But I tell you what, whenever Widnes come forward and spin that ball around as they did for the try earlier on in this half from Darren Wright, they're a good side to watch. And here they come again. Ooh, that was a high challenge. And it's Furbank again. He says it was round the chest area and not round the neck. Make your own mind up. That was a little high.
Yeah, it was a little high, that one, there's no question about it. And he copped him. I don't think he's copped him that hard. I think it's Andy Currier down. He's a big lad. What is he, 6'3"? I think he's making a bit of a meal about that. And I think Mr. Tennant, if he does the right decision here, he's doing exactly what I would do. Give him a good telling off. Tell him any more, sunshine. You're away. You've been simbing once. Now, come on, cut it out. Let's get on with the game. Andy Currier's all right. He's had worse than that. And I just thought he made a bit of a meal. It looked worse than what it was, that, actually.
The referee obviously agrees with you, Kevin, and he has awarded Widnes a penalty and given Furbank the riot act and told him that as far as he's concerned, one more and he might be off for longer than the 10 minutes in the sin bin.
You know, some of these referees, Eddie, when they get you together there and everybody thinks that they're telling you off, what they're actually asking you is what won the 2:30 at ADOC yesterday. But it looks good as far as the crowd goes.
We'll have to take your word for that, Kevin. Here's Tony Myler. And Myler thought he was out of the traps and away. There's some confusion on the pitch as to what the referee's awarded. It's a scrum and it's Bradford's head and ball. And that's what happened. A knock on. Was it?
Yeah, it was a knock-on. Tony lost the ball, regained it. It was half a dozen one, half a dozen of the other. And the only decision that he could give was give a scrum down, quite right. That, actually, I think, is the first free kick for feeding. Definitely signalling feeding. In fact, I can honestly say, this season, I haven't seen a lot of scrums being penalised for feeding. So Mr. Tennant must have thought, well, I'm having a minute, here we go, I'll give one for feeding. just for us, just for our statistics.
So Widnes back in the Bradford 25. Oh, well, he should never release that ball on the first tackle. Pendlebury swoops on it gratefully. There's the offender. Only a young player, David Smith, but perhaps he will learn the lesson of that. McGowan driving his way down the middle. Pendlebury. Good kick again. Tate has to go back almost to his own try line. In fact, he's right on his own try line. And with Caudle in front of him, he's going nowhere.
Tackling very well, Bradford, you know, they're moving up, cutting it out. No way have they got to, you know, really witness. They're allowing Widnes to play the usual game, which is fluid football, missing men out, doing dummies, you know, doing the dummy runs, and they just ain't doing that because they're putting them to ground. And the beauty about it is they're not only one-man tackling, they're what I call gang tackling, and they're taking the man and the ball. And it's very difficult when, you know, you've got such tigerish men around you to release the ball. And to be quite fair, this is the first run Phil McKenzie's had. And, you know, that is what he should be doing more often.
Oh, but I tell you what, this is a chance here for Darren Wright, and that is an almighty error by Bradford Northern, and Wright is over to give Widnes the lead for the first time here this evening. What a mistake from Bradford Northern. But the Widnes supporters who've come across the Pennines here are delighted that Darren Wright has scored that, and this is how it came about. Caudle doing a juggling act, giving it straight into the arms of Tony Myler. He had Currier, he had Wright, he saw that Wright had the field ahead of him, and Mumby wasn't going to catch Darren Wright, and Wright over for a vital touchdown, maybe, for Widnes. He's given them the lead.
Yeah, again, Myler, beautiful vision there, as I said about this lad's football brain. He couldn't give it there to Andy Currier, but he didn't. He knew that Mumby had a better chance of getting Currier than he had of getting Wright. So what did he do? He missed Currier out and slung a beautiful ball out to Darren Wright. And as I said, this long striding winger, although signed on as a centre, is playing on the wing in place of Martin O'Fire tonight. You know, ex-Lee Rangers player, what a beautiful way to score a try. And really against a run of play, and Bradford will feel very, very peeved about that. And Cordell, who did the juggling act there, as we just mentioned, McKenzie has not been in the game. All of a sudden he pops up, bump, a little chip, mistake off it, thank you very much, and this could be really the winning score.
And he's kicked it. Jonathan Davis punches the air with delight. He's well pleased with that effort. Another goal for Jonathan Davis. Floated it over from a quite difficult position, but Widnes have suddenly jumped into the driving seat. They lead now by 14 points to 10. And we've got 9 minutes of the match left to play. And there is a substitution about to be made. And Craig Richards, who's had such a superb game for Bradford Northern, the crowd rising to this young man. And no wonder, he comes off to be replaced by Darrell Shelford.
Yeah, it's no wonder they're making a substitution with the young fella, because if anybody's give 200%, then this young Craig Richards has. Absolutely storming game, no question about it. He's give his all for his club, and that's all you can do. And I think that is a shrewd substitution, because he is tiring a bit. He's in the big league, and he'll only be the better player for this experience.
He's had a superb evening, and it'd be a shame from his point of view if he finishes up on the losing side here tonight and picks up loser's money. Widnes, 4 points ahead, 14 to 10. And Darren Wright's second try of the evening. He only managed actually to score 8 tries last season. And he spent the summer with Steve McGowan at Norths. So that was the tackle count for you while I was talking.
Now Widnes have got the tails up, and you know they're coming powering through now, and really they're making Bradford increase their error rate. And now Widnes are in the right position on the field to do something about it. And I think if Widnes could snatch another try, then it would definitely be a good night, Vienna. And that's a beautiful scrum to one. But he's penalised Widnes for wheeling the scrum. That is two really free kicks that I've not seen for a long while on the rugby field. One for feeding and one for wheeling.
Well, we said at the start of this evening that the Rugby League have sent out an official memorandum from the controller of referees, Fred Lindop, to try and tidy up the scrummaging in the game. And that's a couple of unusual penalties at the scrum in Kevin Ashcroft's book that we've seen here tonight. Whether it will be a seven-day wonder, as Kevin said, we'll wait and see in 7 days' time. Hull Kingston Rovers, by the way, against Warrington on the Sports Channel live at 6:30 next Sunday evening. But we've got a match and a half here, and we've got about 6 or 7 minutes of this game left. Bradford, having led all night, is suddenly making the errors, and they're being forced into those errors by Widnes, who now really do have their tails up and are ahead by 14 points to 10. Well, Craig Richards, the man who's been substituted and who's had such a big game here this evening, is down in the dugout taking a well-earned breather. Let's hope he's got some breath to talk to our reporter Peter Hutton.
Yeah, I just got stuck in. Lads were helping me out, working around. Just hope we can snatch it back now. I think we deserve it. We've worked hard.
Certainly looks tough out there.
Yeah, it's very tough in the forwards. Witness have thrown the ball about a lot, so we seem to be chasing a lot. But I think if we can get in their half, we'll definitely snatch it back.
Could go right to the last few minutes, this one, then.
Yeah, right to the very end.
Thanks a lot, Craig.
Right, thanks a lot.
He's had a fine game. And he looked it, didn't he? He was wringing wet from the perspiration and of all the effort that he's put in out there. And his colleagues, who are left out there without him now, have got some effort to put in if they're to snatch this one back from Widnes. Widnes, though, are in the mood, I think, now to fling that ball around and make sure that the points are theirs. Oh, and that was a nasty bang that David Smith took in the mouth from Steve McGowan's shoulder. Oh, I think he felt that one. What a cruel game, though, as David Smith's out, flat out, as a result of this challenge here from McGowan, and it was purely accidentally, I think, that he got his shoulder in his jaw, but as he's flat out and receiving attention, the referee takes the ball off him and we move on. Tough game, Kevin.
Yeah, but, you know, to be fair, that is an absolutely perfect challenge. There was nothing wrong with it. Hit him with the shoulder. It was just unfortunately catching him a bit high up. And there's no question about it. He'll need a couple of anodynes later on because I should imagine he'll be hearing the bells in between his ears at this moment in time.
And good work there from Mumby under pressure.
Absolutely brilliant fullback, this lad.
The ball bounces back off the corners and the inclined areas behind the goals here at Oddsall, and it bounced back almost into Widnes' arms, but Keith Mumby has been here more years than he cares to remember, and he collected that quite easily.
Roger Simpson at this moment in time is having a little bit of a nightmare. He's dropped two really vital balls there for Bradford Northern when he could have put them on attack. A loose ball there he didn't hold on to, and he could have got the defence really in a tangle of Widnes' then, and for some reason he just couldn't pick it up. Probably have to swap it now and swap the ball and put two handles on it for him, because he's just watching the man at this moment in time.
Well, David Smith taking a breather after receiving that bang in the mouth from the shoulder of McGowan. Grimmer's back on. Meanwhile, here's a chase. You have to be quick to beat Darren Wright. And Darren Wright got to it first.
This is now where Bradford have really got to work, and they've got to peg Widnes down there and hope for a mistake, an enforced error, anything to get the possession now in this 10-yard area, and hopefully they can launch the final attack to snatch the game or even snatch a draw. And, you know, because they have been tackling well, and they should be able to hold Widnes in the 25, and I should imagine you will see a kick from Jonathan Davis or a punt from Les Holliday. But, you know, they've got a hold of me now, last tackle coming up, so they have done the work. They've kept him in the 25, and I wouldn't be surprised now if the ball goes back to Jonathan Davies, and he'll sky it, as predicted. There she goes.
Underneath it is Keith Mumby. But that's relieved the pressure a little bit on the witness line. Now in centre field, Bradford Northern in possession. 2 minutes to go. 4 points the difference. 14 points to witness, 10 to Bradford, after Bradford led for so long. But two tries from Darren Wright has changed the course of the match. But here come Bradford again. But a case of spilling it by Daryl Shelford, brother of the All Black captain, Buck Shelford, of course. Medley's ball to him. He was a little bit annoyed with the New Zealander for dropping that one.
There was a lack of communication there on probably Smedley's part or Shelford's part. If you wanted him to come inside, he should have told him. But that's a good win against the head there for Bradford Northern. This could really be the final act.
Simpson darting through the middle. Witness have got to close the gap here because Bradford are after the points. They've led all night. They're now behind. And this could be their last chance. Pendlebury leading from the front. Right in front of the sticks they are. 1 minute left. Hobbs just delayed the pass at the wrong moment. He's given it to Coloto. Now Coloto can move, but he's got all the Bradford defence with him. McKenzie takes over. Good tackling from Roger Simpson. Davis. Davis going on his own. Good pass out. Oh, and they drop it again. The referee said it came off the leg. He waves play on. What a good game we've had here tonight. Grimmer. Good pick up by Tate. Coming up to time being added on for stoppages. There might be a little bit of that, but not too much. Witness are so close to their first victory of the season. Darren Wright, scorer of the two tries that have turned this game round for Witness. Clinging on there, but a little kick over the top. And the referee says that all the Witness players who were moving up on that kick were offside. So Bradford had better get their skates on here. We're into time added on for stoppages. And he hasn't found touch. Tate did well. Caught it and stepped inside. There's a lot of tired legs out there now. They'll be so frustrated, Bradford Northern, having lost this one. 14 points to 10. We're in time added on by the timekeepers for any stoppages. Coloto shaping to kick ahead. Elects in the end to cling on. And there is the full-time siren. It's all over. And Bradford will be so disappointed that they've lost this one. They led for so long. Darren Wright scoring two tries. There he is, the two-try hero of Widnes this evening, in on the right wing instead of the injured John Devereux, and he moved out to the wing and scored the two tries that has clinched the points and the winning pay for Whitney.